Hello and welcome to 3D Nato. My name is Renato, and in today's video I'll show you how to model this dice in Blender. If you're new to Blender, this video will be a good place to start. Modeling a simple dice will show a lot of Blender basics, and I'll try my best to explain everything I'm doing here. The first thing I like to do is to delete everything in the scene and set units length to millimeters. But for this one, we'll use the default cube to model the dice. Select the camera, the light, and press X to delete them. And on scene, go to units and set length to millimeters. The default cube in Blender has 2 meters, and the most common size of dice, the one we are going to model here, is the 16 millimeters dice. To change the cube size, press N to open the sidebar and set dimensions to 16 millimeters on all axes. Notice that this operation will also change the object scale values. Now we need to reset these values back to 1. If these values are anything other than 1, operations like bevel and inset will not work properly. To fix this, press Ctrl plus A to apply and select Scale to apply scale. To zoom on objects in Blender, use the mouse wheel up and down or just press numpad dot. To rename objects, press F2 and let's rename it dice. Press Tab to go to Edit Mode. Edit Mode is the main mode where modeling takes place. With meshes, everything is built from 3 basic structures. Vertices. The most elementary part of a mesh is the vertex, which is a single point or position in 3D space. Vertices are represented in edit mode as small dots. Edges. An edge always connects 2 vertices by a straight line. They're usually invisible on the rendered image and are used to construct faces. Faces. Faces are used to build the actual surface of the object. They are what you see when you render the mesh. A face is defined as the area between either 3, 4, or more vertices, with an edge on every side. The faces are often abbreviated as tries, quads, and n-gons. Triangles are flat and therefore easy to calculate. On the other hand, quadrangles deform well and are therefore preferred for animation and subdivision modeling. Now we are going to start modeling the dice. To create round edges for this cube, let's use the bevel tool. Press A to select all, Ctrl plus B to bevel, and Enter to confirm. Expand the bevel menu, set width to 2 mm and segments to 4. Now let's subdivide these main faces so we have enough geometry to create the dots. The biggest number of a dice face is the number 6, and for this, we're going to need a 3x3 grid. But that will result in only one quad face to create a dot, and that is not enough geometry. So let's double that and create a 6x6 grid. With that, we'll have plenty geometry for the round dots. To subdivide these faces, we'll use loop cuts. To create a loop cut, press Ctrl plus R and place the mouse cursor until a yellow line appears. As we are going to need a 6x6 grid, create 5 loop cuts. Just roll the mouse wheel up or press 5 on numpad. To confirm the number of cuts, press Enter. And to confirm the position of the cuts, press Enter one more time. Now just repeat the same steps on the other faces. Press Ctrl plus R, type 5, and enter 2 times to confirm. Press Ctrl plus R, type 5, and enter 2 times to confirm. Now all main 6 faces have a 6x6 grid. One observation about dices before we start creating the dots is that the addition of opposite faces is always 7. This means that if the top face is a 6, the bottom one needs to be 1. If the front face is a 4, the back one needs to be 3. And if the left face is a 5, the right one needs to be 2. To make our jobs easier here, make sure you have the loop tools extensions installed. To install it, go to Edit, Preferences, Get Extensions, and install Loop Tools. I'll start on the front face and we'll create 4 dots here. To go to front view, just press numpad 1. For every dot, I'll use 4 faces. By doing this, we'll be able to create circles with 8 vertices. That is why I have created a 6x6 grid instead of a 3x3. Let's start creating the dots. Select these 4 vertices and press Ctrl plus plus sign to select more. Press I to create an inset type 0.5 to set a 0.5 mm thickness, and enter to confirm. Now we need to make 4 circles with these faces, and we use the Loop Tools extension for that. Right mouse click, go to Loop Tools, and select Circle. For the carvings of the dots, I decided to go with the semicircle approach instead of a flat extrude. And for that, we're going to need extra geometry here. With all 4 circle faces selected, press I to inset, type 0.6, and enter to confirm. To repeat this inset one more time, just use the shortcut Shift plus R to repeat last. This will create another 0.6 mm inset on these faces. Now we have enough geometry to create the dots. To create these hemisphere shapes, we're going to need to enable proportional editing. Proportional editing is a way of transforming selected elements while also affecting the nearby unselected elements. The farther away an unselected element is, the less will be affected. This feature is very useful for smoothly deforming dense meshes. Click here to enable proportional editing, set fall of type to sphere, and proportional size to 1.8 mm. Now all you have to do is to select these foremost inner vertices and move them inside the dice mesh. And the proportional editing, with the sphere fall off, will create the shape we want. To select them, just press Ctrl plus minus sign to select less. Press G to move, Y to lock on Y axis, type 1 to move these vertices 1 mm, and enter to confirm. Now let's create the dots on the back face. Remember that to make 7, this face has to be a 3. Press numpad 9 to flip to back view and select these 3 vertices. Press Ctrl plus plus sign to select more, I to create an inset, type 0.5 to set a 0.5 mm thickness, and enter to confirm. Right mouse click, go to Loop Tools, and select Circle. With all 3 circle faces selected, press I to inset, type 0.6, and enter to confirm. To repeat this inset one more time, just use the shortcut Shift plus R to repeat last. Now all we have to do is to select these 3 most inner vertices and move them inside the dice mesh. To select them, just press Ctrl plus minus sign to select less. Press G to move, Y to lock on Y axis, type 1 to move these vertices 1 mm. If by any chance your mesh is going outwards, just type minus sign before hitting enter. Now it's just a process of repeating the same steps on the remaining 4 faces. I'll speed up a little bit to create the rest of the dots, and we'll come back after that. The only thing that I like to say is to create the number 6, we'll not be able to make all 6 insets at once, or it will create 2 rectangles. So create 3, and then the other 3. Now just finish modeling the dots as the one we did before. Just keep in mind that we'll move the top and bottom vertices on Z-axis, and the left and right vertices on X-axis. After all dots are created, let's add an edge crease to them. The edge crease will make sure the borders of the dots are sharp after we add the subdivision surface modifier. A quick way to select these edges is to use Select Similar. Press 2 on keyboard to edge selection, select any of these edges here, press Shift plus G to select Similar, and select Face Angles. To add an edge crease, press Shift plus Z, type 1 to set a value of 1, and enter to confirm. Now let's make this object smoother by adding a subdivision surface modifier. The subdivision surface modifier is used to split the faces of the mesh into smaller faces, giving it a smooth appearance. It enables you to create complex smooth surfaces while modeling simple low vertex meshes. It avoids the need to save and maintain huge amounts of data and gives a smooth organic look to the object. To add a modifier, press Tab to exit edit mode, go to Modifiers, click Add Modifier, go to Generate, and add a subdivision surface modifier. Set Levels Viewport to 2 and disable Display Modifier in edit mode. And for last, right mouse click on 3D viewport and select Shade Auto Smooth. To finish this project, let's create a simple material for this dice. Press Z to shading and select Material Preview. Go to Material and see that we already got a base material for this object. Let's rename it Dice White. All we have to do now is to create another material for the dots. Click this plus sign to add a new material slot, and here to add a new material. Let's rename it Dice Black. Click on Base Color and set value to 0.015 to make it black. Now, all we have to do is to tell Blender which parts of the mesh will use this material. For that, we'll need to return to Edit Mode. Press 3 to face selection, and select these faces I'm showing here on all 6 sides of the dice. Now press Shift plus G to select similar, and select Coplanar. To select more, press Ctrl plus plus sign 2 times so all dot faces are selected. Now, all we have to do is to click Assign to assign this material to these faces. Exit Edit Mode, and the dice is complete. If you're still here, it means you are liking the content of this channel. I really want to thank you for spending your time with me, learning some basic Blender. I hope you have enjoyed as much as I have making it. So please, consider subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it, and leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye bye.